This video will show you some of the basics of editing a paint action sequence. I am in the paint action sequence mode, which is the default mode when you launch Studio Artist. I'm just going to choose this first preset and click action. A paint action sequence can combine presets into a script from all the different image processing modes, such as the Vectorizer and the Paint Synthesizer. You can use it to build up interesting effects that you can save and use on any source image. Paint action sequences are also used for animation and auto rotoscoping. I'm going to show you some simple edits to this paint action sequence. I'm just going to move the paint action sequence window up here, so I can widen it. I'll show you how to play back each step by clicking on the red square. Then I will edit a few of these steps as I go along. Also, I will make sure that recording is off so I don't inadvertently change or delete anything. You should have this checked only when recording a new step. This first step sets the canvas to white. This next step is an auto paint step, and this one I want to edit. Because this is a paint step, Studio Artist automatically switches to the paint synthesizer mode when I clicked on it. So now all I need to do is to toggle to the editor. I want to change the coloring. So I will bring up the paint color source panel in the paint synthesizer editor. The color mode for this preset is RGB match color palette. And what that means is that this preset is looking at the color palette and trying to best match the colors in the palette to the source image colors. These light yellow colors are the closest colors to the skin tone of the source image. And these reds are the closest match to her hair color, so that's why it's choosing those colors from the palette. Just so you know, it's really easy to change color palettes by dragging an image onto them. So, for instance, you can choose your favorite artist's paintings to create a color palette that will match the painting's palette. I'll just quickly show you how to do that by going to Google and dragging an image onto the color palette. For this demonstration, I just want to match the source image colors, so I will change this setting to color, which will now match the color of the source image. To save my edit, I just need to option click on Mac or Alt click on Windows on the red square next to the step that I just edited. Now I will play it back by clicking on it to make sure my edit is there. So now I will continue to step through. This next step is fine, but this step is adding saturation, which I don't want. So I will simply mute this step by checking the mute box so that it won't play back. Mute is actually a music editing term that just means off. The rest of these are all good, but I want to change this canvas texture. So I will undo that with Command Z, or if you are on Windows, Control Z. And just so you know, if I had record checked, I would have just deleted that step by using undo. Since this is a paint synthesizer step, we are back in the paint synthesizer mode. This time I'm not going to edit this preset. Instead, I'm going to completely replace it with a new one. So I need to toggle back to the presets and navigate to the canvas texture category. Next, I'm going to run this pastel paper preset. And then option or alt click the red square, which will replace the old one. I'll just step through to make sure. This next step is just a duplicate of the old canvas texture, so I will mute that step. The rest of the steps are fine, so now I will play back the paint action sequence. Next, I want to export this edited paint action sequence preset to my favorites. There are two ways to do this. The first way is through the menu, by choosing File, Export, Export Paint Action Sequence. Or by holding down the Control key on Mac or right-clicking on Windows and then mouse down in the Paint Action Sequence window. Then choose Export Paint Action Sequence Preset. All presets reside in the Presets folder in the Studio Artist Application folder. All presets must reside in this folder in order for Studio Artist to access them. We always recommend that you save your presets in your favorites so you can easily transfer them to new versions of Studio Artist as they come out. Favorites folders can house any kind of preset. You can make as many folders as you like in your favorites folder. For more information on presets, check out the videos on preset management. I'm going to make a new folder called My Paint Action Sequence and save the preset there. Now, back in the paint action sequence mode, I'll check out my new preset. I'm going to add one more step and show you how to easily update a preset. I'm going to add some edging from image operations. So now, I will turn on record and run this preset. Now to update this preset, I need to go back to the Paint Action Sequence mode. And option click on Mac or Alt click on Windows on my new preset icon. Which will bring up this dialog. I will choose Yes and save the edited preset. I encourage you to create and edit your own paint action sequences.